Hi, this could only be Rides with Chuck. In this video, Voodoo Larry talks about his latest creation, Phantom Voodoo. We ran into Larry at his open house. It's 2021 Voodoo Larry's open house.
Oh, obviously you know who I am after all these years. I've known you since, what, 96.
96.
Like,
so what have we got here?
Many years later, this is my 50 Chevy. I think you did a video of it like a couple years ago and it was in bare metal. Well, it's finished now. You know, a couple years later, it's finished. The second paint job, second modifications, because I already did modifications to it once, and I changed a few things like the headlights, the...
You can walk around on it.
Yeah, sure. But anyway, yeah, I chopped it, hard topped it, did like the Barris style window frames and everything. These are slider windows. This is a Pontiac, 50 Pontiac from a four-door that I moved to the front door. It's got full steel bubble skirts. I did the peaks up on the top. I chopped it 6 inches and 8 inches. I did the peaks on the top, peak on the trunk, all the way down to a peak, very late 50s stylings. It's tuck and rolled on the outside. I actually have my pieces I still got to put on the top of the car. These are 54 Kaiser. This is a 54 Packard. And then the bumper is a 56 Lincoln that I narrowed 5.5 inches to fit the back of the car, which just fit perfectly around the license plate, you know.
I got a question about this. That was like standard back?
Well, back in the day that I've actually talked to a few people that know what they did is back in the day, they actually used to put upholstery outside on the outside of the car versus painting a car or adding different paint, you know, paintwork. It was cheaper to upholster. So that's why you saw guys that would put tuck and roll license plate covers or steering wheel covers, wheel well cover or wheel well panels and stuff like that. So a lot of guys did the tuck roll on the outside. This is just magnetic on. You can see when I take it off there, it's got a pinstripe underneath it. But for the styling, this car is from 1961, 62 era. This was popular back then to put tuck and roll and upholstery on the outside of the car.
Yeah, okay.
And again, later you'll come back and film it. I'll actually have a big piece that goes up on the top, like almost like the Golden Penny Chevy that was done by Tom Lichty back in the day. Well, I did the kind of the same thing for that. So anyway, yeah, so to the front, obviously, you can see I scooped the hood. These are a 54 Mercury grill fender teeth. You can see the tuck and roll down in the fender well there. Those are 54 Oldsmobile with a lot of teeth on them. Functional leg pipes. That's a 52 Packard fender molding that I actually just added that recently. It goes all the way back into the cove there. And then, let me open the door. You can check the inside out. Upholstery was done by Bruce Mapes at Mapes Upholstery, and also Stitch Curl did the tonneau cover, rolled and pleated the tonneau cover. Of course, the dashboard's all pinstriped, as you know, normally I do and stuff. In between the seats is a 1950 drive-in movie speaker. They were made out of, what was that plastic back in the day?
Bakelite?
Bakelites, yes. Bakelite. They're very hard to find because they all rotted out in the sun all these years, but that one's in nice condition. Steering wheel is a 1955 Renault steering wheel. Of course, you had the phone, Barris style phone. There's a cleaning dispenser under the other side there. So that's kind of the interior styling. These windows are removable, so I can take these out.
Yeah.
And I got pockets built in here, so I can take the glass and slide them into pockets back here. Very Barris-esque style, you know.
Is there any chance you could start it?
I could. Hey, actually, the leg pipes are functional, but I got them capped right now. But usually, when on cap, it's pretty loud. You know? It's nice and mellow, you know. And the bumper in front is a...
Hold on, real quick. Did I see a Fisher body?
Oh, the dorsals? Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's
factory-style dorsal plates. It's still the factory seat. But what I had Bruce do is I had him do a, I call it the ass pocket. So a taller person can sit in a seat and see how it's sectioned downward for a taller person. And then on the other side, for like shorter person, whatever, there's a pillow that sits in the seat that takes up the extra 3 inches of space. You see what I mean? For a tall guy, I can sit down. And I have the seat reclined back about an inch and a half. It'd give me more headroom inside there, being 6'2", you know. And it works out fairly well, you know. Uh-huh. Underneath the tonneau, this used to be a club coupe. A businessman coupe had no back seat. This had a back seat at one time, but I got rid of the back seat. My spare tire and all my tools and stuff is back there. So I have an open, clean trunk. Oh yeah, I'm going to show you the trunk too. I have Gene Winfield logged off of me all these years. And the trunk's all like fully upholstered inside too. Reminiscent of the early 60s, you know. And of course I keep all my stuff in there, you know. But nice thing is all my stuff, spare tire and everything is all in the back seat, uh-huh. So I kind of have more stuff. And the reason why the panel's built up is I have air ride and all the stuff, all the mechanicals and everything are all back there. You know?
Okay.
Batteries on that side, on the corner on that side, and air compressors and everything is on that side. Yeah. I always fell in love with this town as a Gene Winfield. I always used like hydraulics or actuators in all his cars, so I had to do that. At least we want to mine. It's on full air ride. I want to show you the front end. Front end's a 56 Oldsmobile, front bumper assembly. And inside the bumper assembly are 58 Edsel inserts turned horizontal versus upright. There's two of them in there. And the old traditional thing was cabinet pulls.
And then I went to my mother's cabinets and I took my gold knobs off the ends of the cabinets that opened and closed the cabinets, and I put it in my grill.
Back in the day, everybody put cabinet pulls in there for their grills. And the headlights, see if I can get these out of here. These are just for show on here. But the headlights are 61 Chrysler Imperial.
Ooh.
And they're Frenched in there. That's the whole assembly.
There's the buckets there.
Yeah, the whole everything. So the whole assembly is all in there. And I just made the covers for temporary, for show, you know. They're made out of acrylic. And then just pop right in there for show purposes only. And then, of course, the body and paint was done by Fox Valley Hot Rods. Matt and the guys out there did a great job, straightened the body out and painted it. And they actually let me go in the booth to actually do the fade, the Gene Winfield fade.
Ooh.
So I was honored to have them let me go in and do the white fade and all the highlights and the down the hood and up on the top and everything. All the scoops and everything are highlighted with white. So I was able to go and do that. So, and then glass guides.
They let you paint your car?
They actually did. I was honored for them to let me do that. It was awesome. The great guys over there. And actually, they'll be here today at open house. I have the Barris Merc in there. Cassandra, the owner, which is Barris' little sister, is coming today. And we're going to talk to all my outsourcers, my paint body guys and stuff. So she's excited to meet them all, too. So she'll be here probably in about an hour or so. She flew in from Hollywood.
Okay.
You know? So it's going to be good to see her because I haven't seen her in a couple of years. But anyway, yeah, so this is it. You know, it's like I said, it's about a... about a year and a half project, you know, it's about a year and a half project, and and here it is.
Thanks for talking to us, Larry.
No problem.
Or is it Voodoo?
Voodoo, Larry Voodoo, or Voodoo, whatever. Oh. Chuck, you know me all these years.